Hi friends, and welcome to a new session with Score with me. Today we are into the third part of permutation and combination, and today we will see some more types in permutations. So let's not waste time. Come, let's score with me. Before getting into the content part of it, let me remind you that previous two videos had the basics of permutations and combinations, and the second video on permutations covered the basic first three types of permutations. So they will give you a gist of what actually permutation is and what sort of questions can be asked from the first two types of permutations. So today we'll be seeing into the remaining part of permutations, wherein we'll see how many ways words can be arranged when letters are not together and when they have to be arranged in odd and even places. So hooray, now we are into the fourth type of permutation questions. So here the questions will be asked such that the letters within the word have to be arranged when they are never together. So never together is either the vowels should never be together or the consonants should never be together, or in the questions particular letters will be defined. Say for example, if we are taking a word like listen, we will be told that the letter I and S should not come together, or any such particular, not only vowels and consonants, any particular others can also come. So in others, what comes is, in question you will be given which letters are not to be taken together. So those are the type of questions that can be asked from this type. So what is easy for us to find is, rather than finding never together, we can find total number of ways and subtract from that always together. So if we were to take the word listen and we were to rearrange the words such that the vowels never come together, let's see how we can do that. How many words, vowels we have? We have got I and E, and they should never be together. So in this case, we have got six letters, and these six letters can accommodate I and E not being together in this way. With the same fixed position for I and E can be here, I and E can be here, I and E can be here. So see, for single fixed position of I, we have got four different cases. And that is why to find never together, it is difficult to take all the cases and then come to a consensus or come to an answer. Rather, if we find total number of ways where no restriction is implemented. So total number of ways without any restriction is simple, the number of letters factorial, isn't it? As we have seen in the previous video. And then always together is also easy because we are clubbing them together, I and E, we are grouping them. So that is much more easier. So whenever a question comes and we have to find never together, keep in mind, rather than finding the ways in which they can never be together, it is always easy to find the number of ways without restriction and then minus the total number of ways in which they are together. Now, if we were to see to find vowels should never be together here, we are taking, they are always together, and we'll subtract from total number of ways without restriction. So listen can be arranged, total number of ways of arranging listen is simply number of letters factorial, because no letters are repeated. So we have got in total six letters. So six factorial is total number of ways, total number of ways. This is just an abbreviation that we have used. Okay, let us have this as never together, let this be NT. Okay, so total number of ways is simply 6 factorial. Since no letters are repeated, we need not bring. Now we'll see always together. Vowels never together had to be taken, isn't it? So we are taking vowels are together. If vowels are together, these will be clubbed as one. Vowels, we have two vowels, they will be clubbed as one. In that case, our complete number of letters were 6 initially, but if we require them to be together, they will be reducing to 5 factorial. Remember, if you have any doubts, please go back to the previous video and watch how this has come as 5 factorial. So now, is that only 5 factorial? No. See, we had grouped vowels, isn't it? So vowels were grouped and they were clubbed as one, and these vowels can rearrange themselves within this group further in 2 factorial ways. So total number of ways when they are always together, that is vowels are always together, is 2 factorial into 5 factorial. So, was that what we wanted? No, we wanted them to be never together. So, never together is total number of ways minus they are always together. So, total number of ways is 6 factorial minus 5 factorial into 2 factorial. That is nothing but 480. Now, for better understanding of that particular type of question, we have taken two questions, sub questions here. How many different ways can letters of the word sister and learn be arranged such that vowels are never together? Okay. Now, let us consider the learn. Vowels should never be together, isn't it? Vowels should never be together. How many vowels do we have in learn? E and A are the two vowels. So, we are taking them together so that we have total number of ways and always together. So, we are taking vowels are always together. Then, the left out consonants, let us write L, R, N. Now, since all these are different, number of ways in which all of them can be arranged is total number of ways in which all of them can be arranged is simply how much? 5 factorial. And the number of ways in which they are together, always together, this complete 5 factorial reduces to 1, 2, 3 and they are clubbed as 1, so 4 factorial. And this particular entity, the vowels within that group can be arranged in 2 factorial ways. So, the number of ways in which when they are together, when they are always together is 2 factorial into 4 factorial and that simply means vowels are never together. So, never together is 5 factorial minus 4 factorial into 2 factorial. 5 factorial is 172. Now, coming to sister part of it. Here again, if we were to come to consider, vowels are together. So, if we are to club the vowels, I and E are the two vowels. Apart from that, S, S, T, R. These are the consonants. And number of ways in arranging the complete thing is, when we group, this becomes 4 plus 1, 5. And 5 factorial. And within the group, that is 2 factorial. Apart from that, S is repeating 2 times. So, that comes in the denominator as well. So, here, when they are always together, it is 5 factorial into 2 factorial. Here, denominator 2 factorial comes, this gets cancelled. So, now, number of ways is 6 factorial minus 5 factorial, 2600 is our straight answer. We have taken a question here where others come other than vowels and consonants. So, this question is, there are 4 boys and 4 girls, in how many ways can we arrange them such that no girls sit together? So, same case as we did for vowels and consonants. Whenever we need never together, what we do? The total number of ways we find and then subtract such that they are always together. Because it is difficult to find when they are never together. So, we have got 4 boys and 4 girls. What are we going to do? We are going to consider girls are together. We have subtracted total number of ways and girls are together. So, let us write them in such a way that girls are together. See here, 4 girls. Suppose we had... We are not keeping any restriction, then we can arrange these people in 8 factorial ways, isn't it? They are 8 in number. So, here total number of ways is 8 factorial. Very simple, complete one, 4 boys and 4 girls. Now, when they are always together, what we did as the case we did for vowels, the same case here. Grouping the girls, we are grouping the girls and considering that as one unit. In that case, when they are always together, our complete group of boys and girls reduces to how many factorials? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 from boys and complete girls are taken as 1. In that case, it is 5 factorial. Now, that was a rearrangement of complete 8 people when girls were together. Now, taking girls as a unit, these girls can rearrange themselves in 4 factorial ways, isn't it? So, when they are always together, they can rearrange themselves in 4 factorial into 5 factorial. So, that is all our answer. So, when they are not together, it is 8 factorial minus 4 factorial into 5 factorial. So, I've simply shown this to show you how you can take factorials common from this to make your simplification easy. Getting into the fifth type and the final part where letters should be arranged in particular restricted positions like even or odd places. So we have taken a question here. Now, letters should be arranged within the word aptitude such that only even positions are occupied by the vowels. Even positions are occupied and vowels. Two restrictions are given. So one is on the position of letters and other is the type of letters. So vowels, how many vowels do we have in aptitude? We have got four vowels in aptitude. So we have got four vowels and we have got four even places. So we need to understand in how many ways can we arrange them there. So it should be in 2, 4, 6 and 8 that these vowels should come, isn't it? And see, whenever we are told for arrangement, we should take that letters are not repeated until and unless it is given, repetition is allowed. And that is why in the first even place, if we have got four letters, we can make them sit in four different ways. That is, either A can come, I can come, you can come, or E can come. Similarly, in the next place, the letter that has come in the first even place cannot be taken. So it will be 3. Then here 2, and that is 1. So number of ways in which even places are occupied is nothing but 4 factorial, isn't it? You can write the number of places and the letters simply because it is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. And here, now left out are the consonants. So if we look at the consonants, how many consonants do we have? We again have 4 consonants, and those consonants are P, T, T and D. So here T is repeated twice. So the number of ways in which consonants can be arranged is 4 factorial by 2 factorial. 2 factorial is because of the repetition of the word letter T. If you require clarification, please go back to the previous video and please watch that once again. It's simply 4 factorial into 4 factorial by 2 factorial. We have taken a question now which covers all the odd and even places, then never together and always together. So it is a combination of all the three types. Now we'll start with this question where the word letters of the word strange should be arranged such that vowels appear in odd places. So totally in strange we have got 7 letters and we have got 2 vowels and 5 consonants. So now we have got 2 vowels and these vowels have to be placed in odd places. So in odd places, 2 vowels, remember. So the first vowel can sit in any of the 4 places. The first vowel can sit in any of the 4 places. Say for example, I had kept it here. Then the next vowel can sit in any of the 3 places and that can be done in 3 ways. So the first vowel in any 4 places in 4 ways and the second vowel. And we have got only 2 vowels. So if I am fixing those 2 vowels in 1 and 3, any 2 places only I can fix. Though I have got 4 places, only in 2 places or 2 odd places I can place my vowels because I have got only 2 vowels. So my vowels can be arranged in 4 into 3 ways. Okay, so 4 into 3 ways because I've got only 2 vowels. If I had got 3 vowels, that would have been 4 into 3 into 2. If I have got 4 vowels, that would have been 4 factorial itself. 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, and this, if you want to remember, can either be also be remembered as 4P2. 4 places, 2 vowels. 4P2, that will give you the same answer. Next, I have got consonants. And these consonants, though I have left over, other than odd places, I have got only 3 even places. But since my 2 odd places will remain vacant since I have got only 2 vowels. So from these 2 places, 2 places will be left vacant. So because of that, the consonants, they are 5 in number and they have got now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 positions. 5 consonants and 5 positions. So they will be arranged in 5 factorial ways. Hence, total number of ways in which the vowels can be arranged in odd places or total number of ways of arrangement is 4 into 3 into 5 factorial. Next, coming to the vowels are never separated, is they are always together. Vowels are always together. Same thing. See, A, E, if we take this, vowels are always together in how many ways? Vowels can rearrange themselves in 2 factorial ways. And the complete thing, it is 5 in number and this is taken as a group. So that is in 6 factorial ways. 2 factorial into 6 factorial is the number of ways in which vowels are never separated. That means they are always together. Vowels are always together. Now, vowels never come together. So vowels never come together is? Never come together is total number of ways minus always together. So we have already found out always together are arranged in 2 factorial into 6 factorial ways. So here if we have total number of ways is in total we have got 7 words, letters. So it is 7 factorial minus 2 factorial into 6 factorial. So simple. Though we have seen many questions in permutations, one thing would have come into your mind that though we are doing permutations, we have not used the formulas anywhere. And the reason behind that is when we are attending any competitive exam, our foremost aim or goal is to reduce our time consumption. And that can be done only when we do things faster. So even though we have not used direct formulas anywhere, we can use formulas the same way as we do in the conventional methods, but that would take you more time to come to the answer. So with the previous examples, let me show you that how formulas can be used. Here we had aptitude and their vowels had to be kept in even places. So arrangement means simply permutation, especially when order is important. So when we are telling odd places, even places, they are all orders in which these words should be arranged. So here we have got 4 vowels in aptitude and 4 places. So 4 places and 4 vowels. They can be arranged in 4P4. And that was what we did directly by writing 4 factorial or 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Same is the case with stranger. They had got 7 words and we had to arrange vowels in odd places. Totally we had got 4 odd places and we had got only 2 vowels. So 4 places and 2 vowels can be arranged in 4P2 ways. Totally 4 vacant places, 2 vowels. So that can be done in 4 into 3. That we wrote there directly. So it is up to your discretion to use formulas or not to use formulas. But always have in mind the faster, the easier and closer to the answer. So that can help you save some time and help you in cracking exams in a much better way. So we'll meet in the next video with few more tricks and few more questions on digits in permutations itself. So please do like and share the videos with your loved ones and who are preparing for exams. Don't forget to subscribe and comment with your queries. So meet you soon in the next video. Until then, thank you.